everybody. Hope you guys are having a fantastic Friday. Great end of the week. Hey, I wanted to go over something with you guys. This is something that would be very important for an individual who's caring for their spouse or someone that's caring for maybe their mom or their dad or really any loved one in their family or just someone, maybe even a friend or relative, and maybe they're the primary caregiver in their life right now. This would be something that we have found this to be kind of the number one objection from the potential member, which would be that loved one, that family member. And we've come up with some really good solutions to help people overcome this obstacle. Because at the end of the day, like this whole service or the service that we provide here at our center, it has not only a huge benefit for our members, but it really has also a really large benefit, a massive benefit for the families who are actually going through this process that are caring for their loved ones. And they might be burned out. They might just want to make sure mom and dad are safe at home, or they want mom and dad to have fun because they're isolated. So either way, this is something that would be important to that that family member that's kind of looking for care for their mom or dad or spouse. So we've come up with a couple responses that are really helpful to help someone overcome this. So, one of the number one objection that we hear, and we're going to actually go through the top five objections over the next couple of weeks, but the number one objection that we hear is that's for old people. In fact, we had a lady one time and she was 100 years old, and she's like, no, that place, that's one of those places that's for a bunch of old people. And she's 100. I'm like, I don't know how much older you can get, but it was funny how her perception, just when her family member was talking to her about it. And sometimes, that perception might be like, adult daycare center. It might just be a made up perception that they have in their mind when their loved one's explaining to them what the center is, or, maybe the way it's coming off to them, they've just already put a mental block because the only thing that they remember is like, maybe what a nursing home was, 40, 50 years ago. So when they're going, through when they're having this conversation with their loved one, it's important to approach it in a way that would at least help them be open-minded to it, because the goal is just to get someone to the center. Once that person actually has visited it and maybe even spent a couple hours with us on a free day, a free guest pass, they're gonna love it. It's they're gonna absolutely fall in love with being here. But the hardest part sometimes, and almost every time, is getting that person here, especially if they're cognitive enough to know what it is and what's going on and stuff like that. So, our number one tips that we give is when you're sharing this information with your mom or your dad. Broke this down into be a volunteer, which would be ideal for your mom, if it was a wife or a female person that we're trying to convince or help have a positive influence over, so that they're interested in coming. And if we look at this kind of be a volunteer, what we're doing is we're sharing, we might be like, hey mom, I found this new place down the street and they're in need of some volunteers. Would you want to come and help me volunteer there for a day? They could really use your help. I think you could help them out quite a lot, quite a bit. And see, the thing is most of the time, we find that age group is really just, they want to find a place where they feel connected. They want to find a place that is going to help them, feel like they're able to help other people. Instead of them feeling like they're the ones here to be helped, they want to be able to feel like they can help others. So using this in a way where like, hey mom, to my wife, hey sweetheart, we're gonna come down to this new place and I was gonna see if maybe you could volunteer with me there. And then what we'll do here at our center, and Debbie and the girls will set up, is they'll get a name badge together, they'll put volunteer on it, they'll give them some different things, some maybe games, and make it seem as if they're gonna help the other person. And what ends up happening is they just start having a blast, they start having fun, and all of a sudden that whole perception that they may have had previously just goes away. And it's just because they just had to overcome this idea of what they thought it would be in their mind. They just had to overcome that. So I always say, maybe before you say, hey mom, here's this new daycare center, this adult daycare center. You know, we always like to refer to it as a senior center. So, hey, mom, there's this new senior center that opened up in town. You know, would you want to come volunteer with me so we can help some people out? And that's the way I would help maybe persuade them to come, you know, through the doors. Once they come here and experience it, then all that objections, all that perception that they may have had is going to go away. So another one, you know, for the guys, you know, for the male figures in the group, for the dads, the husbands, for our male figures, a lot of times what we'll do is, you know, hey, dad, I found this new place down the road. They got a free lunch, you know, and oh, they also play poker twice a week. So they have free lunch and poker. You know, I was thinking maybe you wouldn't mind having lunch with me tomorrow, and we could have lunch together and play a hand of poker. What do you think? And so now, you know, instead of sharing with dad, hey, dad, I found this new adult daycare center down the street. In his mind, you know, now he's like, I don't need any help. Are you kidding me? Like, but in your mind, you're like, I know he needs something, you know, just for the sake of peace of mind, just for the sake of just knowing that, you know, now he's not home lonely all by himself all day. You know, so for safety reasons or whatever the case may be, or maybe you're the primary caregiver and you're like, I just need a break. And you're like just frustrated because you cannot find a way to convince him to come down here. So just maybe taking a different approach to it. Say, hey, dad, you know, there's this new place that just opened up down the street. You know, they got a free lunch and they play poker twice a week. Why don't we go check it out? I'll play poker with you. You know, why don't you have lunch with me tomorrow? You know, more than likely, you're going to find that you're going to have a more successful response to the way you approach it if you approach it in that way. And then that objection, you know, you're not going to get that. It'll make it easier for you to make, you know, the steps forward to getting your loved one here. So again, that would be a way that we might handle that male figure, like I said, the dad, the husband, anyone that's kind of, you know, the macho guy, stubborn, like I don't need help, I don't need care. You know, this might be a way to help get them engaged that way. So, and of course the third option, so it would be live music. So you know, this is gonna work for anyone. You know, so a lot of times what we might say is that, hey, there's a new place that opened up down the street. You know, they have live music every day at 1 o'clock, and they got a barber shop, they got a hair salon, they do hair, nails, manicures, pedicures. So I might change my pitch to my loved one, depending on if it's my dad or my mom, or if it's my husband or my my wife. I might change the way I share that information with them to cater to barbershop versus hair salon. You know, to cater for maybe, you know, nails and, you know, manicures and pedicures to more like, you know, poker and live music. You know, so I might, you know, cater to Frank Sinatra or whatever the case might be. I might, when I'm sharing that information with them, I have a massage therapist on stop, you know, or on site. They also got a movie room. You can watch all your favorite Western movies. You know, this might be just a general way to help get either party interested. And then, you know, hey, why don't we swing by tomorrow and listen to live music, and you can be my dancing partner, dad, and you can be my dancing partner, mom, or to your wife or your husband. And all of a sudden, now that I'm asked them to be my dancing partner, hey, we're going to go listen to live music. You know, all these things are going to just lower that hesitation, lower that wall that they've automatically put up, because, you know, they're feeling like, you know, you're forcing them into something they don't want to do. And again, once they get here and they try it, man, they're going to love it. They're going to have a blast. It's going to be something that they're really going to enjoy. And not only is it going to be great for them, I mean, it's going to transform their lives, but it's also going to make a difference in your life if you're the family caregiver. So if you're the family caregiver and you're exhausted, it's going to make a huge difference. It's going to really help, you know, you feel like you can get some breathing room. You know, if you're just concerned about their safety and you just want to make sure that they're in a safe and secure environment, again, another area, you know, as far as incontinence care is concerned, or just general safety with falling, with maneuvering with their walkers, or, you know, with a wheelchair, transferring in and out of those different things, making sure they're eating. You know, a lot of times what we find is because people are at home alone and they haven't, they've been at home alone for so long and they haven't had that social stimulation, you know, they've slowly like backed off maybe the amount of food they intake. Maybe they don't even have a desire to eat food anymore because they don't have anything to look forward to. Then you get them here at the table and they're talking with their friends. And next thing you know, they consume an entire meal because everyone around them's eating and they're talking and chatting and they're not even thinking about it. And next thing you know, they've eaten their entire meal, whereas opposed to maybe at home, they like take a bite and then set it aside, you know? So just all these little things are going to make a massive difference, not only in your life, but your loved one's life. And of course, you know, if your loved one's just, whether it's safety and security, or if your loved one's, you know, home by themselves, just to help, you know, reduce that isolation and that loneliness would be another, great reason for you guys when you're thinking about caring for your loved one and stuff like that. So anyways, guys, hey, thanks so much for joining me today. We'll go over through the next four objections that we experienced and share with you guys some ways that might help you overcome those things if you're exploring this process. But I wrote a little article, a little note today as well to go along with this. So it's something you could share this or the video, whatever the case may be, but we'll make sure that all that information is accessible to you guys. So, hey, thank you so much for joining. I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend and we'll see you guys soon. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.